All right, Codename Super. When Cooler pulled up to Earth and realized Goku is one of one. Well, maybe one of two, because there's two Saiyans, you know what I'm saying? Hi, I'm Goku. He is one of one. Anyways, bro, listen to me. I am live on Kick. There will be a link to the original video down below. Go check it out. Pull it to the streams.
Oh, nah. I want you to take a good look at this. Like, look at the scenery. They got my boy Krillin Saria laid out. And they up there swinging, going by the
okay, tip.
And the worst part is, before all this happened, they was real life out camping, making their own food and shit. My boy Krillin was chefing up the food, and look, this man is over here having himself a plate, talking about some, damn, this shit good. And goes right back to eating. And hold up, bro. That's not even a plate. He's eating out of the whole pot, making sure no one else
can. Oh, he hungry. Nah, he hungry.
Piece of shit. Meanwhile, we got Hulk's slow cousin just swinging, going around. Then using, bro, like he a
pack. Oh, yeah, by the way, everything that this man is about to talk about, I'm not gonna know Nathan. All I know is that Cooler, his design was pretty cool. Other than that, bro, he about to put me on, because I don't know, bro.
And that boy Goku thought he was a superhero. Look at this.
Hey, stop right there.
Ass pull up. They toss the food and go on away. And look at this man Goku's face. He is mad as shit right now. And I don't really think it's because of the fact that they threw Gohan away. I'm 99% sure it's because he threw his eats away. Like, we've seen Gohan get his ass beat before, and Goku just stood there. But what we haven't seen is some villain tossing away his food. That has never happened. And you know how much Goku loves to eat. This one struck him a little different. So after like 15 seconds of mean mugging them, he like, who the fuck are y'all?
Y'all haven't heard about us? We're Cooler's Armored Squadron.
Who? Facts.
Yeah,
who?
They really said that with so much pride, but didn't realize they had no motion. They're not like the Ginyu Force. They're more like Vegeta. The motionless prince who buys likes. We caught that shit the other day. They hit their own pose too, and that shit is...
Oh, hell nah.
This man down here think he's Spider-Man. He should just be in the league. And bro, we're here just like...
2024. Literally, that green one, he's kind of zesty, bro. He need to join Playboy Cardi.
They hit their own.
Look, look, look. With underwear on? Oh, hell nah.
Pose 2, and that shit is a complete ripoff. This man down here think he's Spider-Man. He should just be in the league. And bro, we're here just like.
Yeah, he tall for real.
But anyways, Goku hit them with the never heard of you, and he had no time for the shenanigans. Just keep the fighting stance.
Stupid.
This shit unreleased. We never seen him do this before. They all run at him one by one like it's a Bruce Lee movie. And peep the schmovement. He ducks under the first one, lets his ass fly by.
Big ass forehead.
About how trashy he is on his way out. Next is the bootleg Hulk with the helmet on. You know he wears that shit in the house. Certified dumbass gets used as a parkour obstacle. Goku locks eyes with whatever that thing is supposed to be, and easily flips over his kick. Yeah, and those were just the first pair of hands thrown in this movie. You knew this shit was gonna be a classic. But they got cooked so bad they had to call a timeout. They huddled and talked it over and came up with a new game plan. They like, hey, you see him? He think he nice. He's not like that. We just gotta jump the confidence out of him. They all run at him simultaneously this time. And I know you just see him standing there looking at nothing, posing. That's how you know shit isn't gonna work. There's no fear.
He not even looking to the right.
And they couldn't hit him. Straight blocks.
Whole Cooler who?
I call it a bad three man. And he's just staring off into the distance, giving any of them shred of eye contact. And now they're all a part of one of the hardest flicks of Goku. You know he put it up on his IG. Goku
just on
like,
me like it all.
Setting them all out the frame. And then
Almighty
the cameraman switches angles to Gohan and Krillin. And look at Krillin. Bro, your ass is not knocked out. There's no way you have this type of face when you get put to sleep. Sitting there gritting his teeth. Yeah, he's just not trying to fight for real. That shit is fake. But the cameraman cuts back to Goku reverse jumping these people. And they set up a triangle offense like this to 96 Bulls. And Goku came in with the tactics. He heard y'all clowning him, calling him stupid. Especially Frieza on IG.
If you could read one full page of a Harry Potter book, nigga.
He shows off the IQ, sends a blast in these directions, making sure everybody stays in place momentarily. But maybe Frieza was right to call him out, because he goes after the one who clearly has the most HP, and tried headshotting him like he did Raccoon. But bro costs 9 elixir, that wasn't happening. He gets him in a grab animation, and the most chopped being in existence was getting ready to hit Goku with the crazy sneak. But Goku's spider sense goes off, making him ready for it, and makes him kick the remaining 2 brain cells out of his own teammate. And this makes them 0 for 3 in trying to jump him, and 0 for 1 in attempting to sneak him. But make that shit 0 for 2 because my boy in the back said I'ma get us a point on the board. But y'all are down 50 for a reason. The whole squad is elite garbage. This man had a
this is sorry, bro. Sorry as the new Avenger. Maybe Shang-Chi. I feel like he hasn't done anything crazy. What about Nova? And anybody, what is he looking like? Other than that, This is sorry as hell. Oh, man.
Squad is elite garbage. This man had a wide open layup and still managed to break.
I'm not watching that.
Turned in everything. But the second he fired, beyond that, reaction time is too quick for him. But after catching it, he throws it up to this thing. And I'm just thinking this man got his head blown off. But of course, he has a retractable head. Like, bro, what even are you? Every second you're on the screen, he's starting to make me a little more mad. I can't lie. They all go down and line up again. And this is where Cooler makes his entrance. And that shit was clean. Cooler steps in and the cameraman just started snapping, getting that clean zoom-in effect. He in his prime.
Oh, shit.
And I'm not gonna lie, that boy Goku looked like he's seen a ghost. I don't know who's more shook, him seeing Cooler or Frieza seeing Trunks go Super Saiyan. Actually, never mind. I thought about it for a second. It was Frieza.
Yeah.
Was stepping back, talking about some. It's those eyes.
And he's sweating.
Y'all knew he didn't stand a chance. But in this next part, Goku gets his shit sold because Gohan is flying through the air, talking about some.
I'm coming to help.
I'm watching this shit like, what do you mean you're coming to help? You're Gohan. Who are you beating in this lineup? Nobody. And Cooler's just looking up in the air, staring at him like,
who the fuck is this?
Then attempts to clip his wings. And Goku, hearing Superman about all the bad father allegations, decided to end it right here. Jumps in front of the beam and protects his son, leaving bro on 1 HP. And he's just like, nah, I can't go out like this. And
so what
Goku
you
turns into Pascal Siakam. He hits a
spin move. I said spin move.
Into a fadeaway key blast. And his aim was really on target. But unfortunately, that shit was weak as hell. So Cooler just smacks it away. And Goku falls in the water, making them lose track of him. A few minutes later, Goku and Gohan finally come out the water. And it is clear
W father, I like that.
Needed a med kit. And this is where Gohan woke up. He remembers he's not Yamcha, decides to be useful, and goes on a journey to get his father some sensu beans.
Yep.
On his way back, I cannot lie, he gets straight up bullied. They shot down Icarus, and Gohan tried to stop him from falling. But Cooler Squad had other plans for him. They kicked the shit out of Gohan, causing him to let go of Icarus, and
that shit hit me.
GG. Gohan is caught off guard, and look at how this man tries to sneak him. You do not need a windup like that for a 5-year-old. He really trying to one-shot him. But Gohan leaves, gets hit with the back fist, and this buff Namekian kicks him so hard that he starts wrapping around his
leg. Yo, his spine is gone.
He looking like Kevin Gates at that one concert. He lobs him up to Jace's cousin, and Gohan is just getting
old.
Went from an O to a U, and this man is straight up ecstatic.
This is a little kid.
After the hit down, he gets punched out the air, and he just stands there palming him. And yeah, you know this is a top-tier Dragon Ball movie when there's a Piccolo pull-up. He fires the key blast at him. Turns around like, who the fuck just did that? And he just standing there like, it was
yeah.
My man's had one of the hardest pull-ups of all time. And it wasn't those one and done shits where he gets one clean hit in and doesn't do shit for the rest of the movie. Nah, he was out there moving. It starts off with Piccolo standing with his arms folded, waiting for somebody to try it. And Piccolo's cousin follows his special graph, fuck around and find out, tries attacking him, finds that he only put a hole through the cage.
Huh?
Then Piccolo teleports right above him and right in the head, leaving a whole ass dent in his helmet. Yeah, real soon he better be doing nothing but barking. He's gonna take his helmet off and look like this.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
His friend comes in and gets absolutely no licks in. All that aggression to get blocked,
weak,
and blocked again. Yeah, absolutely no get back to see here. He sees his friend get cooked and chases after Gohan. He said, fuck that, I'm going in the easier lobbies. Not gonna lie, this is just showing how sorry the squad is. I haven't seen them beat anybody over 4 feet tall. Straight feasting on Gohan, Krillin, and Kai Sinet. He chases him.
They jumped the little kid, by the way.
Stops his fight to fire at bro. And this dumbass living organism goes in front of his blast just to flex that he got a retractable head. My guy, you were literally out the way. And bro pops up talking about some miss me. Bro, he wasn't going.
He wasn't going for you.
For his family member who gets his shit boom.
Oh.
This leaves his squad in pain.
He's not Cooler, bro. He can't deflect that.
To hold him in place. And somebody got to give that boy Piccolo an Oscar because he was faking it crazy. Sold it so well that he started to talk shit and Piccolo was sitting there plotting. Hits him with the devious grin, palms his face, and puts the attack on him, turning him into a crispy treat. And after all that, he turns his attention to Jace's brother. He teleports to him and starts tearing him up. And guess what he does in response? I'll give you a hint. It's what anyone would do against a 7'5 green man.
I'm leaving.
Ran. Bro, yep. He started flying through the forest. And this man, Piccolo, is childish as hell. Look at him. He's not even trying to catch him. He's just trying to show that he's faster than him. Basically hit bro with the Jackson Storm, told him it's over and passes him. But he said, I'm not going to get done like McQueen. So he sends a blast his way. And Bro over here is really delusional, living in his own world, because no one believes his attack really one-shotted him, but himself. Look at him diabolically laughing, feeling like he's won the fight for sure, but he didn't. All that laughing just for Piccolo to come out the woodworks unscathed, not even a
smile
on his clothing.
Smiling.
He could return that shit to the store if he wanted to. He goes on the branch and pulls out the pre-alpha Keyblade, and years later this would prove to be a lethal attack, but right now, this shit is trash. Look at this finishing cutscene ass animation. Did all that just to put a hole through his shirt. No blood or anything. Just a tear. And wow,
really?
He really showed me. Here I was talking about how he could return the fit. I guess he can't anymore. Good job. He attacks Piccolo again and he catches it. Then gets kicked in the sky where they stand off again. And this is where it happens.
They make them noises just to put fear in the opponent's heart.
Hey, 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 hey.
All that breathing shit. They want you to think they punching so fast. Like Bruce Lee, that ain't nothing. That's a nigga making that noise.
It's.
You fall for it. That's you. I'ma eat it.
But yeah, that's the end of Piccolo for today. He done. He got forcibly clocked out. But now it's time for the main event: Goku versus Cooler. So yeah. Cooler's just holding a Piccolo, like, is this your man's? And Goku's just like, hey, now you better drop him. And that is the worst thing he could have said. Because he lets go of him, and Goku opens his arms to catch him. And I'm just sitting there like, bro, is he gonna miss this catch like he did on Namek? But nah, it was worse. While he was in mid-air, within catching distance, he boomed.
No!
And not once, nah, three times.
Yo!
And my boy Piccolo looking crazy, and the cameraman cuts to Cooler, and he was just like, damn, I even mean to do all that for real.
Cooler's cold!
But he had to lock in, save face, he's a villain. Puts on the devious grin. And here comes his shitty ass minion. Bro wanted to be involved so bad. Hits him with the right hook and gets completely ignored. And I'm not gonna lie, I think I'd rather get blown up three times than have this type of disrespect. Not even looking his direction. Shit's crazy. He getting treated like Mr.
Yeah,
Satan.
And the crazy part is,
if someone had to choose to be a character in the Z universe, Mr. Satan or you, they're still choosing Mr. Satan. That's how you know you're at the bottom of the barrel. You might be beyond trash. But anyways, let's get shit started. He powers up, and Cooler's sitting there like, pull up then. And Goku's like, all right, bet, and charges at him.
Got
his eyes linked out. His ass was not ready for all that. He's seeing stars.
One
and he's
punch
just like,
concussed.
Hey, your order not finished. Gives him a side of tough punches. And he is just piecing him up. Look at that anger. This is the shit Itachi was trying to instill in Sasuke. But instead he went to the man that bit his neck. I just know he fell to his knees when he heard about that. But back to the fight.
Sasuke was moaning in there too.
Kicks him away.
Oh shit.
And he didn't let bro rest for a second. He said, I'm not done. Goes in for seconds. Flies right at him and gets his punch catch. And he's just like,
whoa, brother, whoa. Now, you got too much dip on your chip.
And sends him for a swim. And if you know Dragon Ball for real, Goku does not do well underwater. That shit makes his overall drop by 20 points.
Hell nah.
Going 0 for 4,
all that training
all
for what?
Attacks. And back out there, he was damn near connecting on everything. But after going 0 for 4, Cooler gets confident. Even hit a smirk just to move his arm out the way and try hitting him with his tail. Yeah, that move was so garbage that he was just like, hold on, bro. Let me hit you with something different. Hits Goku with the Ki Blast, but he throws it away. And right here is where Goku figured it all out. Got used to being underwater. Goes at him and hits him with the left hook. Leaving a dent in bro's head.
Damn, concussed.
Has his eyes rolled up. He looking crazy.
Hey, yo.
And if I was him, I'd make sure no one could get their hands on this photo. This is legacy ending. He finishes the combo off by grabbing his tail, spinning him around, and chucking him out the ocean. And in my head, I'm watching like, damn, Goku's really cooking him. Not using Kaioken or Super Saiyan at all. And Cooler over there is in his third form. He should low-key be washing Goku.
Third form? What is his regular form?
Goku the worst. Made him whip out the old reliable spirit bomb to try to handle him. And that shit still didn't work. Meanwhile, his brother over here is hitting a grand total of 0 hits, posing no threat. He knew he couldn't go out like that, so he reveals his fourth
form. Ooh, this was cool.
And this is when I really knew Toriyama knew ball. Alongside this clean-ass design,
yeah.
He gives him that Optimus Prime.
Yeah, the little
and
thing.
And exactly how Optimus Prime would do it, too. Says a one-liner and puts the mask on. And even though it was cold, I could only fear for what's gonna happen to Goku. He goes at him with his arm out, and Goku's just like, hell no. Dips out of there very far away. He thinks he's in the clear for a good second, and then out of nowhere, Cooler comes from his right and puts a knee to his gut, flying across the map and slamming into the wall. Making the front of his stomach touch his spine. Yeah, real soon he's gonna start moving like the inflatables at the car dealership. After that, he gets into the down air, sending him into the water. Then he's just looking down like, about to dive in. Goes down into the water with him and hits him right in the gut. Yeah, these attacks are brutal, and it's hard to watch Goku getting cooked like that, but bruh, y'all know you have a whole nother form that you're not using. And I'm just sitting there wondering
he's
why.
He's just testing.
He
just,
Goku pulls up behind him and just stands there. Oh, he got his hair up, pump faking the audience into thinking he's gonna go Super Saiyan. But it's just Kaioken. Disappears out of pure speed, and the prime cameraman is just showing us every angle until it stops, and he just hits Goku out of thin air. Looking cold while
he
doing
read that.
That shit had Goku so discombobulated, he started hitting a fadeaway dab. And just look at Cooler standing there just flexing. Goku flies away, comes back, and he's still there just holding it.
Fuck it, what nobody think. I'm him.
Goku couldn't get disrespected like this, so he tries hitting him, and he disappears. And while Goku's hitting the darn it, Cooler comes back and elbows him just so he can get the solo click off. And after all that, we caught Goku fleeing the scene. Packed his things up and left. Told him, you got it. But Cooler's just one of those. Pulls up behind him and says, I know I got it. Spikes him to the ground and has him sliding. Yeah, he wasn't gonna let him walk away and be the bigger person. And the shit this man does next gotta be nightmare fuel. He flies through the water like this an Iron Man scene and uses all that momentum to gut check Goku. And that boy Cooler takes
Bro, are you gonna go Super Saiyan or what?
He hits him with that heavy grab animation, slams him to the wall, drags him up, and slams him back down into the ground. And while I'm watching all this happening, I'm just wondering where Vegeta at. I thought he would have pulled up by now.
Oh, God.
At one of those entrances.
I'm here for the fun. Thank you for the follow. What's stopping me from redeeming 80 push-ups right now? Chill. I went to the gym today, bro. I'm so pleased.
But nah, his ass did not leave the house today. He ducking. Cooler puts Goku further into the ground, creating an unnatural disaster. Splitting the sea like Moses, man's used his body to recreate a biblical event. After that, Goku rises out the ground, looked out all reliable, and the beam was looking majestic. I thought it would have him running or at least do some damage, but no, he just stands there and flies right through it.
Do it!
And he's just like, oh nah.
Yo, Goku.
Knowing that he's cooked, and Cooler comes out with the previous three-piece. Pops out the beam to punch him out the frame.
Ooh.
And he got my boy Goku looking like he wanna sub out, watching this maybe hit the Arthur, cause why ain't he go blonde yet? He gets his shit beat and elbowed into the wall. And as if that shit wasn't enough, he slams his body not once, but twice. And it's here that I figured out why Goku didn't go Super Saiyan. He just wanted to be theatrical. Look at him falling dramatic as hell. And then he starts picking up the bird. But hey, pay attention now. This Android 16's favorite part. He starts to get up, starts transforming with the bird in hand. And then he raises his arm up and finishes the revive. And now he's up and about flying.
Oh shit.
That's what I'm talking about. This shit means something to me, man.
And the bird goes up to him and he's just like, hey, good luck with that, my boy. And goes
you got
on
it, bro.
His day. But this is where we see Goku transform into a Super Saiyan.
He
gets Cooler with the meanest glare. Look at that shit. But I'm not gonna lie though, I thought I was gonna witness one of the greatest fights. Like, we saw Goku cooking Cooler in base form, and then we saw Cooler cooking Goku when he reached his fourth form. So naturally, I thought him going Super Saiyan would just make this shit even. But I literally couldn't be any more wrong. Cooler goes for an attack, and Goku's just right behind him, grabbing his arm like he had misbehaved.
Oh, whole time, Cooler just wasn't strong enough. Goku was just playing with him like he was like, bro, if I go Super Saiyan, it's gonna get boring because I'm gonna beat you. And Goku is all about having fun. And who just followed us? I'm here for the fun. Yo, Chad, it's all full circle, bro.
And this shit is really embarrassing for Cooler, so he's just like, unhand me. His ass did absolutely no damage. I started to feel bad for bro. Because anything cold he does is gonna be canceled out by this sorry ass ending. Goku tells him to give it up, and he starts walking back in fear. Goku's like, where you going? Goes up to him and drops him out the frame. Right here gotta be one of the most disrespectful things I've seen Goku do. He leaves him and stands there just so Cooler can take a step back and ponder on his actions. He just like, damn. Do I even gotta be a villain for real? This shit not even fun. I just blow up planets, and then what? I just go on to the next? Fuck it. I'm ignorant. He uses the blast to make Goku lose track of him, and when he looks up, he sees that he's holding a big-ass supernova attack. And this is basically bringing a shovel for your own grave. Because Cooler throws the attack, and Goku stands 10 toes, catches that shit, and you could probably guess what happens next. He throws it right back at him, blasts it away, and Cooler's just like, what? Impossible.
See ya.
He gets his ass taken off
dead
the
rat?
Map, and he goes into the sun. And yeah, that's the end of the video. Thank you for 413k. We moving.
That's what it all came down to, chat. He just knew that if he went Super Saiyan 2 or whatever, Super Saiyan, that's it. It just would have been boring. Yo, Cooler, you did all that for what, bro? To then die by your own attack? Couldn't be me. Cooler, you look too cool. And then you got smoked. That's crazy, bro. Shout out Codename Super. W Video. Yeah, man.